Hallelujah.
Amen.
In the last 3 weeks, we've been dealing with a very critical issue that has to do with life and godliness, that has to do with heaven and success here on earth, and I've brought all the issues that have been raised under it under one big subject called bringing a golden offering. Okay? I've told you that there is no reason why anybody should come to Christ in the first place if they don't want to go to heaven. It's a useless thing to come to Christ, because the name Jesus Christ means the anointed one and his anointing. Okay? The Savior, the one who saves his people from their sins. And if he saves us from our sins, where does he want to take us to? Heaven. In his Father's kingdom. Not only that, you know Matthew 6:33 plainly tells us that seeking first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, all other things shall be added. So the kingdom of God is sought first, is first and foremost. But there's another thing, which is second. And that is the fact that here, God wants our life to work. Because he himself knows that if on earth here our life does not work, it has a way of affecting the way we seek the kingdom. And I've told you that the same thing that is responsible for our going to heaven is also the same thing that is responsible for our becoming very great here on earth. And this morning, I want to round the message off by letting you know that, be rest assured, if you follow the principle of Christ, you will not only make it to heaven, you will break through fantastically well here on earth. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Breaking through or going to heaven is not an uphill task. Alright? It's not a mountainous job. It's just one easy job. You know, Jesus said, my yoke is easy, my burden is light. But he said, we have to learn of him. There is something to learn of him so that we find right. Let's say that before I go on. So don't look at life. Going to heaven is so not easy, so uneasy. Breaking through here on earth is so difficult. No, I refuse to agree with you. Let all men be liars, let God be true. When you have learned what God wants you to learn in Christ Jesus, you will find rest to your soul. The word rest can be used for, if you go to the book of Hebrews chapter 4, can be used for entering heaven. And it can also be used for entering into peace, prosperity here on earth. I don't like to preach any message that only looks at heaven alone or that looks at the earth alone. I want to preach awesome message. The Bible says God has given us all that pertain to life and godliness through the knowledge of him who has called us unto glory and unto fortune. So anytime God talks about heaven, he also talks about earth. Anytime he talks about being with him in heaven, he also talks about you experiencing his glory here on earth. Because it's only one factor that is responsible for both. Just like you go to a medical doctor and he tells you, I want to give you a medicine that will cure your barrenness. Now, that same medicine will give you children, will allow you to have children. That's what he's saying in essence. It's a double-edged sword. The word of God is a double-edged sword. Okay? It works here and there. Okay? So, God does not only want us, you know, because I've seen loads of churches and I've seen loads of pastors. I've seen so many places. The only thing they preach about prosperity, prosperity. You've got to make it. And God is not a poor God. And there is nothing, absolutely nothing is wrong with prosperity. Without money, we can't pay for the all we are in now. Without money, all the things that are done in this place cannot be done. Without money, you will not have traveled from all the places you traveled to come over here. Money must have done it. Without money, you can't have electricity in your house. Without money, you can't have petrol in your car. And nothing absolutely is wrong with having money or prospering. Ignorance is the greatest mountain that anybody has to face in any generation. Okay? When people are my people perish for lack of knowledge. And it so pains me that God did not say that the people. God would have said in Hosea chapter 4 verse 6, the people perish because they don't have knowledge. The most painful part of it is that God said, why people? And you remember when God was talking in 2 Chronicles chapter 7, if my people who are called by my name, so God has a people, somebody say amen.
Amen.
Like that song says, God's got an army marching through the land. Deliverance is their song, hidden in the heart, everlasting song. Joy forevermore, in this army I've got a part. In this army I've got a part. So you got to understand that God has got an army, God has got a people. And if you are born again Christian, washed by the blood of Jesus, you are one of God's people. But that being one of God's people guarantee your heaven or guarantee your prosperity here on earth? No. Say my Hosea chapter 4 verse is my people. You can be his people and still perish. That means barely surviving, struggling through life. You can be. Jesus began to weep over Jerusalem. He said, oh Jerusalem, oh Jerusalem, oh Jerusalem. How many times will I gather you like a hen will gather her chicks and you are not willing? In other words, Jerusalem, city of peace, city of the great king, city of God, is not breaking through because there are some things he's not listening to that Jesus is passing across. If you listen to the words of Jesus about prosperity on earth, you will prosper, really good, big time, by excellence. If you don't listen to it, you can be like Lazarus. You are so holy and you're going to heaven and you are good for nothing here on earth. So now, as I was saying, I've been to churches and I've seen pastors, I've met with pastors, I've met with Christians. That the only thing they would deal with, they just deal with all the earthly prosperity. And I mean, I bet you God, they prosper in such churches. Physically. Because there are principles that may prosper physically. You know, most of the unbelievers that are prospering don't apply the principles of God. They just apply the principles of arithmetic, how things work, the principles of business. And they prosper. Okay? And I've also seen churches where the only thing they deal with is heaven. Heaven, 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 and heaven. They are so heavenly useful and earthly useless. They become a bunch of nuisance here on earth because of heaven. Before we go to heaven, we will deal with the earth. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I give you two scriptures quickly in the Bible. In Proverbs, Solomon said, the profit of the earth is for all. In every labor that is a reward for the talks of the leaf, flow into penury. The heavens of heaven, Solomon, David said, the heavens of heaven belong to God. The earth has he given to the children of men. God spoke to Abraham, follow me, I'm taking you to heaven, but here on earth I'll make you great. He said, I'll bless you. Everybody who blesses you will be blessed. Everybody who causes you will be cursed. Through you, the families of the earth, not the families of heaven, the families of the earth will be blessed. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Anything you open your heart to in Christ Jesus is what you get. It may take time for you to get there, but you will get there. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Alright? Okay? God joins the two together. How to enter heaven and how to prosper here on earth. And I hope this morning that the people that I'm speaking with, I never want to get to a point in my life where I will be speaking to people who already made it and they are not hungry anymore. Because when anybody gets to a point where he is or alive, he's not looking for anything to do anymore, he's not looking to make anything anymore, then he's not a person that should be in the church. Like the rich fool who, after harvesting his crop, said to his soul, now my soul, eat and drink forever and ever, just be eating and drinking. And God said, tonight, somebody say tonight, your soul will be requested of thee. And God has to take his soul that same night. God does not deal with people who are filled up. You remember when they were giving prophecies during the time of Jesus Christ, that the people who are filled up, God has sent them away empty. But the people who are hungry, he has sent them away filled.
One hungry soul that is so hungry for God to fill up and give me 10 cities. I tell you, it's a matter of time, those cities will become poor. Hunger has power. Okay? And the only thing you know now about a hungry soul, about somebody who is so hungry, who is so thirsty after God, the only thing you know now is the time that is hungry, when God will answer him. You will not know him anymore. That's the reason why the Bible tells us that this poor man cried to the Lord. The Lord heard him and delivered him out of all his troubles. Amen. Now look at Matthew chapter 11. Are you there? Matthew chapter 11. And don't tell me all these things are difficult. They are not difficult. It may take time, but it's not difficult. I said it may take time, but it's not difficult. It may take time, it is not difficult. Look at from verse 25, Matthew chapter 11, and Jesus said, at that time Jesus answered and said, I thank thee, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because thou hast hid these things from the wise and the prudent, and hast revealed them unto babes. Even so, Father, for thee so it seemed good in thy sight. All things are delivered unto me of my Father, and no man knows the Son but the Father, neither knoweth any man the Father, save the Son. And he to whomever the Son will reveal him. Come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, I will give you rest. I will give you what? Rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me. For I'm meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest to your souls. For my yoke is easy, my burden is light. Jesus here talked about rest twice. Talked about entering into prosperity. Talked about, you know, entering into the destiny of God for your life. Talked about, you know, entering, receiving the end of your desire. Jesus talked about it here. But here, the crux of the matter is that Jesus said, my yoke is easy, my burden is light. The only thing I want you to do is to come and learn of me. It's easy to get to heaven. And it's easy to prosper here on earth. Alright? But it's the same factor. One factor that leads to both. Learning of Jesus. Being desirous enough, I want to go to heaven. Being desirous enough, I want to prosper here on earth. Because there's no use to be here on earth without prospering. This world does not have use for poverty people, poor people. The world in which we live, there are demands that you have means for you to have mouth. If you don't have means, you don't have mouth. A lot of the things all of us are praying about that God will deliver us from, you are only economically impoverished. If you are not economically impoverished, there's no reason to be praying about those prayers, those prayer points. If you are economically liberated and economically buoyant and economically all right, you won't be in such problems. There's no reason to be in such problems. Okay? And God addresses all those issues. But this morning, let's go into what I want to just show us, Matthew chapter 13. So the last point of bringing the golden offering is, I want you to offer yourself. That's the topic of today's message. Offer yourself. Offer yourself. Don't forget, while I was closing 3 weeks ago, I told you of a king. Of a king that the army of Israel moved against him. And because they moved against him, you know, he didn't have a way of breaking through. He didn't have a way he can conquer the army of Israel. And the Bible says he took his son and offered his son on the fence. And there was great indignation against the children of Israel. God says, stop. That means no matter what troubles happen to a man, there is always a required offering to offer unto God, and it will stop. I need you to know the fact that when a man gets to a point where he really desires to break through and look up to God, it will come. That's why the Bible says in Romans chapter 12, that whosoever are called upon the name of the Lord shall anybody can go to heaven. Anybody can break to public breakthrough and breakthrough to the left, right, and center. Not minding their age. You could be 70-year-old, you can break through. You could be 50-year-old, you can break through left, right, and center. It depends on when your anger, hunger, and anger become explosive. And I believe that I'm talking to people this morning whose anger and hunger is explosive. And all to be able to take that which God wants for them in this world. Somebody say amen. Amen. So Jesus, in Matthew chapter 13, look at verse 8. Let's start from verse 8 before we go back to the beginning of that chapter. Now, what I want you to look at is verse 8 of chapter 13 of Matthew. Verse 8. And here the scripture declares, but all that fell into good ground and brought forth fruit, some an hundredfold, some 60-fold, some 30-fold, and all that. So Jesus here began to tell us that people can really break through. People can profit with life. People can produce all that. So why can't you be one of the others? Others here means it can be anybody. Anybody's name can be written here. Hello? Anybody's name can be what? Can be written all that. That means others are falling by the wayside. Others are falling short. Others have made shipwreck of their life and destiny. But all that fell in a good ground and broke through 30-fold, 60-fold, 100-fold. Some people got to 30 and said, that is not what I'm looking for. Some people got to 60 and said, this is not what I'm looking for. And some people got to 100 and said, God, now you have taken me from bad to good, from good to bad. Now I want from bad to glory and from glory to glory, and there is no end to the glory of God. So here, Jesus typically gave us a focus that anybody can break through so far you fall on a good ground. And how do you fall on a good ground? Offer your own self profusely to God. You just open up your heart. You know, David was talking in the book of Psalm 121. And you know, this morning, one of the things God told me is that a lot of people call upon me, it is true. A lot of people want to prosper, it is true. A lot of people come to church, it is true. But you see, until your submission is completed, your elevation will not be produced. You know, Paul was talking about it. He said, when your obedience is complete, then I will avenge all disobediences. Submission, total submission to God. David was saying, I will lift up my eyes to the hills. From whence comes my help? My help comes from the Lord. You know, in that statement, you know, David was simply saying that, well, I've been looking at the hills, but God is not in the hills. God is in the spirit. And those who worship him will worship him in spirit and in truth. So David was trying to say, I've been distracted. That is why help has not really come. But from the moment I put my total focus on God, my help comes from the Lord who makes the heaven and the earth. Anybody can receive help. Anybody can break through. Anybody can be at the 100-fold. Anybody can get there. Anybody can become a big man. Everybody can become a big woman. Anybody can accomplish the destiny of God for their life. And what is the destiny of God for your life? Jeremiah 29 verse 11. I know the thoughts that I think about you. They are not of evil, they are of peace. To give you a future and an expected end. To give you a glorious future. Anybody can get there. Anybody can produce unprofitable result. What is unprofitable result? One leg in heaven, one leg on earth. You are significant on earth. In heaven, your name is known. The only thing God will not get involved with is anything that will give you fame, that will give you fame and glory on earth. But in heaven, you'll be useless. He doesn't get involved with that. Only the devil does that. And Matthew chapter 4, the devil came to Jesus there and said, to see this world and the glory thereof, they belong to me. I can give you if you bow down to me. And there are people who are bowed down to the devil, the Illuminati group, you know, people in secret court and in all those places who are bowed down to the devil. All of them who have money, you know, unnecessary money that you cannot, you money. They are there. That's not what I'm talking about. But I'm talking about people like Abraham. I'm talking about people like Isaac. I'm talking about people like Jacob. I'm talking about people like Job. I'm talking about people like David. I'm talking about people like Solomon. I'm talking about people like Joseph. I'm talking about people like Daniel. And we have lots of them in our time. Who broke through God? Who became significant through God? They did not only become significant, they ruled the world of their time. The world of their time was at their feet. Alright? It was written of Solomon that because of the wisdom of God that God gave to me and riches, that all the kings of the world sought to let the wisdom of God through Solomon. All of them came to Jerusalem. They did the obeisance for him. They bowed down to him. I'm not talking about the rich fool. I'm not talking about people who got their stuff from the devil. I'm talking about people who obtained help from God. And Jesus, thank God, that he came to the earth. He did not deny the fact that we can prosper while on our way to heaven. We can prosper while on our way to heaven. Your vision can come true. The plan of God for your life can come true. But how? From verse 2 of this chapter, I read, and let me explain a bit. From verse 2, and the Bible says, and great multitude were gathered together unto him, so that he went into a ship and sat, and the whole multitude stood on the shore. And he spake many things unto them in parables, saying, behold, a sower went to sow, and when he sowed, some seed fell by the wayside, and the fowls came and before them. Some fell upon stony places, where they had not much heart, and forthwith they sprung up, because they had no deepness of heart. For 6, and when the sun was up, they were scorched, and because they had no root, they withered away. For 7, and some fell among thorns, and the thorns sprung up and choked them. For 8 is the place I started. But other fell into a good ground and brought forth fruit, some 100-fold, some 60-fold, some 30-fold. So Jesus here explained that people who do not prosper in him have some serious issues. Which, when pressed by his disciples, he began to explain the issues. Let me look at it. Hallelujah. Let's look at where Jesus explained this issue. From verse 18, he began to explain it. And he said, hear therefore the parable of the sower. When anyone heareth the word of the kingdom and understand it not, then cometh the wicked one and catcheth away that which was sown in his heart. This is he which received seed by the wayside. Verse 20. But he that received the seed into the stony places, the same is he that heareth the word and honor, with joy receive it. Yet he hath no root, but journey, stays for a while. For when tribulation or persecution arises because of the word, by and by he is offended. Verse 22. He also that received the seed among the thorns is he that heareth the word, and the care of this world, and the deceitfulness of riches, choke the world, and it becomes unfruitful. Verse 23. But he who received the seed into good ground is he that heareth the word, understands the word, and beareth fruit, and bringeth forth some 100-fold, some 60-fold, some 30-fold. So in other words, Jesus is saying here, anybody who will prosper in the kingdom to come and here on earth will be a detailed person, somebody who gives detailed attention to the word of God and to run through the process. God has a process. Number one, the one that fell by the wayside. Those are the people who cut corners. You want to get married, you cut corners. You don't stay on the word. The word of God cannot work for a person who does not stay on the word. They want to do ministry or articulates, I mean the joint, what do they call it? Joint matriculation examination, or whatever that they call it in Nigeria. Then the school even sat also. Some people never need it. People sat for them. They go to campus. They never sat for any exam. They went through the school, but the school never went through them. So they are produced as half-baked, untaught, unprocessed, really, really unprocessed people. And you know, in quality control, we are told that if the process is all right, the product will be all right. Now, if you have never seen anybody who is tilted about process before, it is our God, the Almighty. They call him the just God. You will go through every bit of the justice. It doesn't cut corner. You will see, they will start teaching about miracles and magics next week. You know, some people want magic wands. God is not a magician. He doesn't have magic wand. He's a miracle worker, and even miracles have this requirement for them to work. They can work, but they have requirement. For instance, he said, if you pay your tithe, I will open the windows of heaven, I will rebuke devourers. You want a pastor to come around and just pray. Devourers are rebuked. God said no. That is a requirement of instituting for devourers to be rebuked, and that is pay your tithe. The Westside people are the corner cutters. They like to cut corners. They like to make, you know, money from a new ways. And the Bible says, the bird of the air will come and take away that which they are doing. In no time, it will no longer be there. So they will not come to him and say, why didn't I prosper? No, God doesn't have anything to do with welfareers. Westside people. No. You don't cut corners. If it is God who has to deal with it, that's why when I started, I told you that the same thing that leads to heaven is the same thing that leads to prosperity here on earth. If you can't cut corners to go to heaven, you can't cut corners to prosper through God. You cannot. That is why after some time, all the churches where they're jumping up and down, I'm telling you now, prosperity is coming your way. Take it now. Take it now. It's coming. After some few years, those people come to their pastor and beat their pastor. Slap the pastor and say, you are a fool. You can cajole us to give our money. We give our money. We jump up and down. And then nothing has happened. The Bible says that if a man be a hearer of the word and a doer of the same, not be a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the same. The Bible says, this man shall be blessed in all his deeds. That's a way to be blessed. His delight is in the law of the Lord. In it does he meditate day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. Bring forth his fruit in his season. His leaf will not wither. Whatever he does shall prosper. God is a detailed God. If any pastor has asked you to cut corners, it's because he wants to wind up your life mid-age, like ostrich. The Bible says they sit on their head, they don't hatch it. In the middle of it, they are taken away. God is not a microwave miracle worker. No, he's a detailed miracle. There's a process God will take you through. Somebody is just born again, you'll be a prostitute. You just got born again. Under 2 months of getting born again, say, Lord, you just give me a husband. And the husband you give me is a pastor. God doesn't do that kind of nonsense. You get born again, go through the Sunday school, go through the regiment, and God processes you for the work he has prepared for you, for the glory he has prepared for you. That's number one. What about the people on the rock side? Those are the people who don't take root. Sunday medicine. They come to church on Sunday. They can never grow. They never take root in Christ. They look like signposts. I am a born again Christian, you know. They are shining. I am a born again Christian. Only one little problem will suit them. Only one little thing. Hey, your pastor, his car crashed and he died. It's enough to take them out of faith. Say, how can a pastor die? How can a pastor's wife die? I've seen people like that before. Many of them, they don't have root. And Jesus explained the greatest principle of Jesus already stipulated how breakthroughs come, how you can make it to heaven and make it on earth. Somebody say amen. Isn't it good? Make it to heaven, make it on earth. Then, the third one, the people on the tummy, saw that the tongue sprang up and choked them. People who care about everything. The only thing you have been thinking about, the reason why you came to church and the reason why you stay in the church is because you are just looking for a man. And every message the pastor is preaching, all you are thinking about is a man. Every message the pastor is preaching, all you are thinking about is how to make a business deal. Every message the pastor is preaching, all you are thinking about is how that thing will just happen. You don't have your focus on God, the cares of this life, the worries of riches. Let me tell you, anybody who wants to come to God or believe he is, and is the rewarder of those who diligently seek him, that is a time to seek God without. Hello? That's a time to seek God without. You don't have an answer to your prayer. You are still committed to it. Somebody say amen. You don't have a feeling anything is going to happen. You are still committed to it. God doesn't like people who are in season, people are out of season. Paul talked to Timothy. He said, preach the gospel. Be instant in the season and out of the season. Then we are out of season. Like some people, the only time they can dance to God is when the music is good. When the music is bad, they can dance to God. When they come to church and there are a million people, they're jumping up and they say, that's my church. That's my pastor. When you come to church and you meet them, after people say, what is happening in this place? And when they say, praise the Lord, they say, ay, 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 ay. You're not a Christian is like a thermostat. A Christian is not like temperature. Temperature, when the weather is cold, it's cold. When the weather is hot, it's hot. Thermostat changes it. It can change the hot to cold and cold to hot. The Bible says the heart of the righteous speaks trusting God and is not afraid of evil report. You need to take root in God and at the same time, open up your heart that even if God is not going to do anything, I will serve him. It's a basic test you have to pass before you move on. Hallelujah. You know the three Hebrew boys? Everybody prays, isn't it? You want to see the appearance of Jesus. Oh, Jesus, in this my situation, appear. I just want to see you. My pastor said that you appear to him or her. I want to see you. You must appear. If you want to speak Nigerian language, say you must appear to me. You are down there, appear to anybody. Like I used to have a guy who just got converted. He's not a big pastor in Benin, Roland. He got converted. You know, he was with those 400 people who preached to him, doing drugs, and then he got converted, and he began to work with us in the office. Then we turned his name to sample me. Because anytime he's praying, he said, hey, the Almighty God spoke to me that as you go to under the bridge, and when I got to under the bridge, I saw a big jeep. Even me, I didn't have car. As his pastor, I didn't have car. He said, I saw the jeep. So when he now come to prayer, Father, sample me your jeep. He's over 30 years now, he doesn't have one single car. He's not learning the rudiment of ministry. Some of you want to jump. Jumpologists. You don't even want to have a husband before you have two children. Because you're just doing an order. You are deciding for God. God, by now, I'm supposed to have two children. See, some of you don't understand the word of God. You don't know that God is so faithful, he can't leave you, you know. Somebody say amen. I said, God is so faithful, he can't leave you, you know. He said, these children, I'm supposed to have children 13 years ago. Are you telling God that he's unfaithful? Are you telling God that that the demons are more powerful than you? Except if you've been living your life in sin. Anybody that will live godly must suffer persecution. What sin was Abraham committing for God to delay him for 25 years? But God had to give him an accolade of the father of faith. And if you are a father of faith, faith is the substance of things hoped for, evidence nothing. For we walk not by sight of our faith, but by faith. And God wanted to name him father of faith. Let me tell you this before I go on. That is a program God has designed your life for. There is no prayer that can sift it. Ezekiel was a prophet in captivity. That was where God wanted to use him. Daniel was a shining light in Babylon. your heart and say, why am I not like that? God should have slapped your mouth. Because the Bible says, you should not tell the mother that gave birth to you, why am I like this? It's an abomination. It's a way to dishonor your mother. When you are rooted in the word of God, it may take time, you will get there. The devil does not have power to stop a child of God. The people who produce 104, 64, 34 years, could the devil stop them? Did he have power to stop them? He does it. The devil does not have power for you as a child of God. The devil lost his power 2,000 years ago. The power of your destiny, not to go to heaven, to make it on earth, is in your decision. Decision determines destiny. You don't stay by the wayside. You get rooted in God. You are always putting your heart on the affairs of this life. Any junction you get to, and God says, this thing you are good, thing is not good. You remove it. David, you are getting angry too much. Deal with anger, remove it. David, you are in a hurry. Deal with anxiety and remove it. Let me tell you, basically, some of you, God prepared you that is when I have done with you about 25 years of your relationship like Abraham that will show you to the world. Let me tell you the reason why. See, the breakthrough you are looking for, you are so excited about it. Your life is a part of a bigger picture. There is a foundation for many generations. I want you to listen. There's a foundation for many generations God wants to lay through you. If so many of us were not stuck in this city and stuck in this nation, do you think we would have brought this job to this level where we are doing our businesses around and running around the street? One pastor posted on the Facebook the other day, he has had a church at K2 for more than 16 years. And he wrote, he said, anybody who did not come to church because the senior pastor is not around is not saved. And I replied immediately, I don't usually reply him. I said, maybe he's saved. Maybe the senior pastor needs to sit down in the church instead of running around the street. Somebody now commented, he said, truly, truly, pastor, since you left, the church has been very few. People have not been coming around. Is that not a message from God that you should stay in your chapel? He's running around the street. Everybody's running. He said, it's because I'm not around. What if the person you left to handle the church cannot handle the church? Okay? What if the required level for their feeding is not there? So when you are not around, then they go somewhere else to go and feed. Hello? Can you feed an elephant with monkey feed? What you feed a monkey with? Can you feed an elephant with it? No. And it's running around the street. And some of us go pray to God and say, God, no matter what it takes for your will to be done, just do it. And God sticks you down somewhere like a sticker. Just comes your bone. Now in that place, I say, oh Lord, Almighty God, can't I move? As you're saying, can't I move? God is using your life to radiate his glory in the life of somebody. Just wave your hand to God. He's a wise planner. The glory of God is getting on somebody's head through you. Somebody, hey, in heaven, there's a great joy over a soul that is saved. That 1 million thousands of people who want to be going around the street to go and see who are already saved in their church. And most of the time, this running around will run around. When those pastors come and they run around, you just discover that they are not at their best. There's no place that I've been at my best than in this church. Because I'm able to say the truth the way it is. You don't know where you go to, you don't know what the pastor wants you to say or what he doesn't want you to say. Then they are now, you know, they are humbling you more than they should honor you. So you don't even know what to say. Oh, daddy, hey, pastor. After some time, they say, mommy. But in the church, everybody look at you and say, pastor, I don't like the way you preach that message. Say, my brother, sorry. But tomorrow, I have to come back. You are able to give the truth. And you can see people's life changing. And people's life are being rebooted. I say, John, God has got a plan. And the devil can tamper it. God has a plan. He was telling Jeremiah, where Jeremiah was making noise. Hold on, you have been together to me like a liar. I will not preach your word again. And God just spoke another one and said, you are my battle axe. He said, with you, I will break the nations in pieces. He said, please. Look for somebody else. God said, I've made your face an iron face. John the Baptist, when he was asking questions, say, who do you think John the Baptist is? He was asking his disciples. They say a prophet, more than a prophet, a priest. He said, no, those who wear good cloth are in the palace of the king. Say, more than a prophet, rocket man that can face Israel. You have seen, you generations of vipers. You think prophet being fed by kings can do that? Prophet being fed by tight people's tight can do that? All the demons that we are fighting in this city, you know, some people who gather together in the recent time and say, what rubbish are they saying? They gather together also and say, we have found out in the whole of this city, there is no other pastor than you and Pastor Sade with the works that you have done in this land. Staying and sticking with the truth and saying the way it is. Saying it the way it is. And we give glory to God. He's got a plan. The devil cannot tamper with his plan. But you've got to be guilty with the process. Don't jump gun. Don't jump the queue. Don't be by the wayside. Don't receive one message about prosperity or one message about marriage and say, ah, I claim my husband and receive one. If you need a good husband, prepare yourself for a good husband. If you get a husband in the church through seduction, another person will get him away from you by seduction. You know what I mean by seduction, and you know what the trousers you wear. Now when you turn, the man, it's like the man is already putting something. So you say, this is the man. And the man comes to the pastor and says, I found a woman after my man. And say, how do you mean? Say, that is the woman God has given to me. And most of the time his hand is in his pocket, using it to pin down the thing that is that won't allow him to pinning it down. His bomb that has attracted him. You'll be in trouble very soon. Bomb attracted him. But somebody you got in the place of prayers, who can take the person away? Are you listening? I said, somebody you got in the place of prayer, who can take him away? A church that is built on prayer and the word of God, what can make it fall? A home that is built on the revelation of the word of God, what can make it fall? Abraham all went through hell. He came back to heaven. He came back to where? David went through all the wilderness. He came back to be crowned as king. Because it was God from the beginning that anointed him. Absalom hijacked kingship. He died. Ahithophel hijacked authority. He hanged himself. Judas went ahead of himself to want to be rich. He died. You know, I jack nothing. Just go through process. Let me tell you as I round up. I am confident of my God. I am confident of my God. And I know he's able to keep that which I've committed unto his hand against that day. I am confident of this God. I got confidence. He who has brought me thus far is able to perform the rest things that concerns me. He who starts a good work in me is able to complete it unto the day of Christ. My God will perfect all that concerns me. He's able to bring to completion that which he has started. No demons have power over me. You are a friend of demon if you have any sin in your life. Any unclean sin, you are a friend of the demon. That's why what is supposed to happen to you yesterday will not happen until 3 years to come. There's no reason for that. But there's a process God takes us through. God takes us through process. You cannot be a good product if you have not been well processed. The pastor that came to preach Bible went yesterday, he was talking to women. He said, you women, you know, somebody can be blessed in the glory that is like making a coffee. How many minutes does it take to make a coffee? But all this soup, a lot of you have given me to eat in this church, don't you know how many hours it takes? So some people's glory just comes like coffee. When coffee's man is finished, soup does start. He can use 1 week when you put it inside freezer. And you still bring it out again. And you are heating it. It took you so much time and money to prepare it on like coffee. Coffee is 50 cents per cup. The soup that we eat is not. Some of them could cost you as much as 100 euro. Some of them cost more than that. Okay? So God is preparing you for a glory. You cannot miss it. Are you listening? You cannot what? You cannot miss it. happen to you. You see, pastor, he himself even just got into ministry and they post him to a parish. I said, this is my wife, it's Mommy P. Mommy P is going to preach tomorrow. Please let us honor her. Instead of allowing what you call Mommy P to go through with you. She herself does not know anything. Let her go and learn. The best way to perform effectively well in life is to learn. Is to go through process. You can't circumvent it. You go through process. Then you become a big product. When you now become a big product, have you not seen so many products who want to rival Coca-Cola? Where are they? They were in your country, they were in my country, they were in so many countries. They will rise for 2 years, they fall. Standing, where is standing? But Coca-Cola, they took their time. The secret is passed from generation to generation.